Greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome back to Pink Panther and Passport Peril. We are currently in India and we're on a mission to put some marigolds over, what was the name? The Indian girl, Inrani's grandfather's grave, which is something that I never thought I would hear myself saying because, well, we don't do that, we don't bury our dead, for the most part. Yeah, there's like a lot going on here. This, I don't know what that is.
Try my Jai.
What is it?
Tea. I insist you sample a cup, dude.
I'd like to think so.
Oh no, dude. It means milk. Do you want some?
Hey, I'm a feline. I don't turn down, dude.
That's some dark ass tea. That is some very dark chai.
What can I get you?
Sugarcane, straight up with a twist. Delicious.
That's not a sugarcane, that's a tender coconut. What?
Not for free, my friend.
The marigolds that we need for her grandpa, right?
Oh no, your outfit is all wrong. Ew, what is that horrible pink fabric? Double knit?
I'm guessing he's somebody from Bollywood, from the looks of it. These guys cannot be interacted with. There's Bilpuri and Masala Dosa there. And... oh, I can only talk to this guy again, apparently.
I love it. Do you love it? It's you.
I see.
To me, this ensemble says, yes, I milk goats in the afternoon, but come evening, I change my blouse and I'm ready to partay! Woohoo! Should I wrap it?
Yeah, that reminds me of Jawaharlal Nehru. That's a historical figure in India.
Oh my goodness gracious! It was made for you! Is it just me, or do you love it too? It's very slimming.
Yeah, I do not like that.
You look to die for! Take it off, I can't stand it!
Right then. This guy here, the vain guy.
I'm a huge star, baby!
Not as much.
Want to see me charm this neck? I'll make it worth your while. How's this? If you can charm this snake as well as I do, you can have some of my wife's flowers for free.
Okay, you're on.
Now you.
Okay, now how do we do that? The snake ran away? Oh no.
Oh, your playing was terrible.
But I played in band. Mrs. Nagel said I had potential.
My snake didn't find you the least bit charming. Now I have lost her for good.
I'm sorry! I said I'm sorry! I'll find that snake and charm her if it's the last thing I do.
Now we need to find this poor man's snake as well. Oh, all the extra work we make for ourselves. I see. We're supposed to give him some money, I suppose. For the record, that's not a beggar, that's just
hey,
a saint.
Hey, Spice Man, do you know where Varanasi is? Thanks anyway.
How can you not know where Varanasi is? Seriously. It's like the biggest city of significance in India here. Like, if you're Indian, you know where Varanasi is. And, oh yeah, so for the record, this guy is most likely a saint, and, well, saints in Hindu, in the Hindu custom don't exactly go around preaching the name of God and stuff like that. They essentially live as ascetics, they beg for food. And these days people give them money. Earlier, back in the day, they used to give them food. So yeah, they live like an ascetic. They beg even for their food. Or collect whatever they can from the forests and stuff, so yeah.
If right treat, my friend, try some bel puri or masala dosa.
Let me try some bel puri. Light on the bell, extra puri if you can.
Yeah,
I think I might prefer the puri to this masala dosa. Hot, hot, hot!
Yeah, the Americans react that way.
So, this is bel puri. It's puri good.
Glad you liked it. Then there's this guy with the monkey.
I have a ripe and juicy fruit.
I think I'll write a song about a man who lost his snake.
I guess that's all that we have here. Might as well head on.
That's so, it. This is bel...
Traveling on top of the train, huh? And we are there.
I know you're here, Snakeheart. I can hear you breathing.
Why does this look so tribal? I mean, you do find stuff like this inside caves in India, but you don't typically find this in villages. Okay, I see a host there. Ah, there's the snake.
Namaste.
Namaste, kid. Say, have you seen a little snake? About so long, kind of purple, see? Wearing mascara.
Finders keepers, losers weepers.
I see.
So, she is here. Let me talk to her. Let me see her.
Walk away, Panther. I'm nothing but trouble, see? I'm all wrong. Bad news. Damaged goods. Hanging crooked. Twisty as a snake.
You're talking crazy stuff. Just crazy. Why, when I saw you in that crowded market, eyes like daggers, a mouthful of venom. Why, I thought you were the most beautiful reptile I'd ever seen. You've got charisma, kid, and don't you forget it. Now, get your things. We're going home.
Sweet talker.
And I'm guessing that was supposed to be an impression.
Don't tell me I can't charm a snake. Shoot.
I'm guessing that was supposed to be an impression of that guy. He doesn't even have room to sit on top of the train this time around. I'm guessing that was supposed to be an impression of that Australian guy who used to love animals. What was his name? I forgot. Like, there was a guy like that. Alright. One snake for the snake charmer. The icon for the snake seems very minimalistic.
Will you ride?
You found her! Go see my wife. She'll give you some jasmine.
Jasmine? I need more marigolds though.
I charmed your husband's snake, so to speak.
Not so easy to do.
He said you might give me some flowers.
Jasmine!
Pretty sure this guy might have an idea.
Oh.
Let's try giving the flower.
Jasmine, I will give you one piece of information in exchange. Is that fair?
No, because I have more than one question to ask you.
Then why did you shake your head yes?
I didn't. I shook my head no.
Listen to this.
Listen close, my panther pink, for things round here aren't what you think. What is our yes is your no. You must not let your ignorance show. Take time to learn the things we know. A boat won't sail without a row.
A boat won't sail without a row.
It was the only thing that rhymed.
I still don't get it.
Look, Panther, it's simple. You shake your head side to side, and in India, that means yes.
Oh, really? So you've got it backwards.
No, you do.
And no, you.
No, you.
Well, I guess we're both right. Kinda. Say, can you tell me how to get to Varanasi?
Are you gonna tell me how to get to Varanasi? This guy still probably doesn't know the way to Varanasi.
Hey, Spice Man, do you know where Varanasi is? Where?
Right away is east, my friend. Too far to walk. You've got a long journey ahead. Would you like some spice?
Sure, thanks a lot.
Feel free to sample what you like.
So apparently that guy was saying yes when we asked him the first time around. That's why we had to give him the jasmine. Nice.
I am the great Polly. I do not want a cracker. I can foresee the future. Show me your palm. Is this possible? You have got the longest lifeline I've ever seen. It goes on and on. You're gonna live forever.
Oh, wait. Seems I just have a piece of dental floss stuck to my lens.
You'll be dead in a week. kidding.
And I guess we have sampled the spices. Now, how do we get to Varanasi is the question.
Feel free to sample what you like.
Long journey, huh? Now, which way is the exit? The exit was here last time round, but where is it this time round?
The world don't move to the beat of just one drum. What might be right for you might not be right for some.
Whoa, that was heavy.
Yes, I learned it from Gary Coleman. I just love him.
All right,
I'm a huge star, baby!
I know that.
I love it! Do you?
Maybe one of these guys here?
I have a ripe and juicy fruit!
Can't exactly track.
Reunited, and it feels so good!
A fried treat, my friend! Try some bell puri or masala dosa.
Wait, Peter's
guessing stuff. So, this is bell puri. It's puri good.
So, can we give any of this to any of these guys here?
I don't need any cooking tips. Thank you very much.
Yeah, it would be sort of rude to do that, wouldn't it?
Achoo!
And that's all he did. This guy maybe?
Ah, yes, spice! I put plenty of it in my last roll. The director looked at me and he said, Malik, you are the spiciest actor I have ever worked with! I think he called me Paprik Malik, because I made the roll so hot and spicy!
I guess spice is not the solution for now. Let's try the bird's feather. Although I have no idea what it'll do, but yeah.
Now what are you planning to do with that, big boy? Coochie coochie coo!
Is this guy supposed to be gay or something?
I'm no featherweight! I'm a huge star, baby!
I think we already got that. Can't exactly keep the feather here either.
I have ripe and juicy. Oh, go ahead and take one.
Hello?
Pink, please hurry. I'm worried about the children. Things are getting really weird here at the camp.
I'm still in Bombay. How far is Varanasi?
Quite far. Get the train. I'm having problems with communications. The weather is very bad. I can't reach the jet pilot.
Train to Varanasi, huh?
Yes, apparently we were supposed to wait for this gold troop, which actually never happened the previous time around, so I reloaded my save and did this section again. So yeah, let's talk to her and she'll take us to Varanasi. I have to look the solution up.
Anyone know where I can get the train to Varanasi?
Victoria Terminal? I'm on my way there now! Follow me!
Victoria Terminal, huh?
Goodbye, pink friend.
Come on! You missed the train!
Aren't we? Yeah. Strange to find such a bug in this game. Ah, BCB guys right there. Both the guys actually. Oh, they eated him off the train. That's sad. And we're back here, huh? Now what? Should we go meet the... Water? Well, looks like he doesn't desire presence there. There's some stuff here.
Somehow it's not me. Sorry. Get it? I said sorry.
Yeah, that's what that dress is called.
Reminds me of when I was a kid.
That rap. Well, looks like there's some water, but we need to figure out how to get it.
Rice is nice.
Yes, yes it is. Rice is nice.
How far is Varanasi from here?
No clue. They don't really want to talk to us. Okay. Alright. That's all you say. There's some cow dung there.
That's a healthy heap of dung!
Yep, yep it is. Question is...
The people in this village use my branches to brush their teeth, and so should you.
That's a neem tree, apparently. The thing is, what are we supposed to do here? We've got some rice, and we've got some spice, and we've got some fruit. Don't think the tree would have any use for its own poop. Maybe we could give her the fruit. Who knows? I guess not. The spice? Of course not.
My mama uses rice in her curry dish.
I really don't think we could be using anything with the dung, who knows? I don't see any place where I can use the rice either, so... The solutions are... The puzzles are as obtuse as ever. I mean, this is typically why I don't play puzzle games, because... Well, the solutions are... obtuse, typically. I guess he doesn't want any. How about a fruit then? Okay. No fruit for the dung. What am I supposed to do here again? The temptation to just look up the guide again is strong right now, because this is the second place that where I've been stuck. No, problem is nobody's exactly saying anything either. Maybe let's try the well again. Maybe it has something for us. Apparently not. Or was the tree trying to tell us to use its branches or something? Let's try talking to the tree more. Ah, of course.
The people in this village use my branches to brush their...
As should I.
That's a healthy heap of dung!
Can't exactly go in there anymore.
Welcome! Did you know in India, pink is the color of welcome? A pink panther! You're most welcome here, my friend.
Well, thank you.
So busy, I didn't even have time to take lunch. I am behind in my work. Oh, excuse the horrors of my bowels. My empty tummy is vengeful.
I guess... he was not talking to us because our breath stank. Our breath stank. I'm pretty sure he could not digest plain rice, so let's give him this fruit.
Oh, thank you. If I can ever do anything to repay you, just ask.
Yeah, what can you do for us?
Oh, thank you. If I can ever...
Yes, Panther?
Oh, thank...
Hi, I'm Chamunda.
That's another name for Durga, the warrior goddess.
My father weaves fabric, and my mother tends to our house and farm. We live over there. See you later.
I see. And of course, there's a cow here, so let's...
Do you belong to this house over here?
Are you kidding? I pretty much get free run of the joint. I don't know where you're from, but cows are worshipped here. I mean, literally. I do what I want, I go where I want, I eat what I want.
Sounds like a sweet deal.
And why not? I supply the dude. Dude is very important, after all.
Well, you don't have to tell me about the importance of dude.
Panther, I'm parched. Grab me a little something to drink, would ya? Could ya? Come here.
Alright, so now we need to figure out how to get something for her to drink.
Remember how you said if I ever needed a favor to just ask?
Absolutely! You're just my groaning belly, boss. For that I owe you. What would you like in return?
How about a little pot?
Oh, pot! It's more but forgive me, of course!
Now we can find some pieces to store the water. Alright, it feels good in these games when you're making progress, but when you get stuck, it's boring. Especially when the game doesn't even give you any hints. And the problem with game design in general is that developers...
Oh, thank you! My throat was bleeding!
Really?
Mother! Mother!
Yes, dear?
We need some milk for tonight's supper.
Of course, dear.
Would you like to milk, Mother?
Oh, I don't know.
Milk the cow!
I'm milking!
Right. So, the problem with game developers is that sometimes they try to be subtle. And when you try to be subtle, you end up being too subtle. And as a result, whatever hints you think you might be dropping tend to get lost in translation. And this happens in everyday conversations as well, actually.
Go on!
Yeah, how do we...
Oh, go on! Oh, go on!
How are we supposed to milk her then? I guess we can milk her with the pond.
I haven't got all day, you know?
What else do you do, huh? You just roam around and eat. What do you mean you haven't got all day?
This is one of Mother's most plentiful milkings in weeks. Please, join us for dinner.
Why, thank you. I'd be delighted.
Well, looks like Panther's getting free food. Alright, I think we're supposed to talk to the woman.
I am late with dinner. Can you help me?
How?
I need water, rice, and spice to make my curry nice.
That rhymes.
Yes, rhyming things helps you remember.
Now, how are we supposed to get the water? Let's give it a rice and spice first.
Thank you. Now all I need is water and spice to make it nice.
A bit spice for you as well, but I just need the water though. You couldn't give me the pot back, could you?
I am late with dinner. Can you help me?
Sure, I can. How about some spice? Looks like turmeric.
Thank you. Now all I need is water.
How do we... Let's ask him.
Yes, Panther?
Can I trouble you for one more pot?
Yes, one last time. But after this, I must draw the line. I gotta make a living, buddy.
Kind fellow. Kind feller. Giving us another pot of water. Well, in which we can get water, that is.
Water, rice, and spice. It makes my curry nice.
Except, I mean, the rice, you don't exactly add the rice into the curry itself.
It is so hot, so we eat outside. Eat, eat!
Shouldn't we...
No, we eat first, then my mother and Chomanda, then my wife.
But why?
Men need the most strength. We must stay healthy. Then the mother and the unmarried daughter must eat. We cannot let an unmarried daughter become unhealthy. If we are to find her a husband, then my daughter-in-law can eat. She already has a husband.
So things are done a bit differently here.
In many ways.
If Chamunda fell ill, what kind of ad could I place for her in the Hindustan Times? Thin, sickly child with deep cough seeks husband? How many would reply?
Say, are you friends with the little girls who live across the way? Do you ever invite them over to dinner?
They would not come to dinner. They are Brahmins.
Brahmins?
Their father is a priest. Brahmins are high up in the caste system.
Caste system? I don't suppose you'd be willing to explain the concept to me in a simple yet lyrical song that I could really groove to.
Here we go.
Don't want to shock ya, but what I'm about to tell you might rock ya. Ow, well, there's long time been a tradition. We call it the caste system. You're born into your caste, there's not much that you can do, but be the best you can.
or simply trying to muddle through. Once there were four different castes divided by profession, you did the work of your caste, feast, famine, or recession.
Caste system is what you're born into. The caste system will need for us just to keep. The caste system defines social position. The caste system is
part of India's tradition. There were Brahmins, Ao, Kshatriya, Vaisyas, and Shudras too. Now there's so many others. I couldn't name them all to you. Last was the outcast, whose treatment was unkind. In the social structure, their caste came last in line. Referred to as untouchables, labeled as unclean. One man known as Gandhi spoke out and called this treatment mean. They could drink from the wells where water was got. Touch food meant for a higher caste. Ow, it may as well rot. Sign.
Caste system's what you're born into.
What you're born into.
Caste system will need for us just to keep. Caste system defines social position. The caste system started in the years tradition.
Gandhi felt the handling was cruel and unjust. Years of wrongful treatment in Mahatma they could trust. Adopting an untouchable girl took a people under his wing. Then the Indian government tried to abolish the whole thing. Passing laws that they hoped would prohibit caste discrimination. That was their attempt to try and integrate the nation. You'd be dead wrong if you assumed discrimination was a thing of the past. Think about the place that you call home. Who are your outcasts?
So the anti-discrimination laws didn't work.
It's a start.
Please! There is still very much discrimination here, particularly against women of all castes. In this village, it is considered inappropriate for women to disrobe to bathe. Only the men should take off their clothes and bathe in the pond. We are to remain fully clothed and only pour water over our saris, not to mention the whole dowry.
Do you like the women's saris?
Yes, they're very colorful.
I made the fabric myself. My wife dyes patterns. I am taking some to Varanasi to sell.
I need to go to Varanasi too. Can I travel with you?
Why, yes. I'd like the company.
So, basically the caste system got reinforced when India was invaded by the Mughals and, well, the British. Before that, there were castes, but it was more of a socialistic community and people more or less, you know, used to do their bit. And that was the extent of the caste system. I mean, there are people who are rulers who belong to the lowest caste out there that there is, which is known as Shudra. So it's not as if caste system was a very strict defining line for what people can or cannot do until the Mughals essentially started that system, and then the English sort of reinforced it. So yeah, these days, however, sadly, there is a very prevalent, you know, issue regarding that. I mean, even with the thing about women being like, how do I put this, and inferior gender, that's also something that was not historically the case. It is something of a more recent addition. Even because if you look at the modern design of a sari, that is not how Indian women would actually historically wear saris. It sort of got changed during the British rule, during the British Raj. They wanted the women to look more modest and civilized, so they made them wear petticoats and blouses and made them change the layout of the sari to actually cover more of the skin and become modest. Before that, I don't really think, especially if you look at ancient depictions in temples and stuff, the women didn't really, you know, weren't really that bothered with covering themselves up. So it actually used to look quite aesthetic to a degree. Anyhow, moving on. This guy here.
Want me to get your back?
Jai Gurudeva. I am in meditation. Leave me alone.
And there's a skull there.
I hate to tell you, but this river doesn't seem like the best place to get clean.
This river is for cleansing and blessing the soul, not the skin.
I would hope so, because... Now, I would not have done that.
This is Shiva's river in Shiva's holy city.
Who is Shiva?
In Hindu mythology, Shiva is the creator and the destroyer. There are over 2,000 temples and shrines in Varanasi. Many are dedicated to him.
I'd like to visit one.
Only one will greet non-Hindu visitors.
Now, here's the thing. You're free to visit any Shiva temple in Varanasi, but Varanasi is supposed to be known as Shiva's home. And skulls like this, like I said, it is supposed to be considered one of the most sacred cremation grounds in India. So, yeah, people get cremated here left and right. some of the crematoriums are actually on the more holy ones are actually on the banks of the River Ganges. And the tradition is basically you just spread the ash into the Ganges, let it take the ashes away. That is considered a proper way of cremating somebody, or seeing them off rather. That's all she does.
Shaba, abale, abale, shaba, hai,
hai! I wonder where these Punjabi folks came here from.
I dip my sari in the holy water for blessings. Holy water, that's cold!
I'm surprised she didn't say holy cow. That's all she did. All he did, rather. That temple isn't even supposed to be in Varanasi. Where are we?
Hello, I am the priest at Durga's temple, the only temple that allows non-Hindus. I'm trying to find the cemetery where a Hindu friend might be buried. There are no Hindu cemeteries in Varanasi.
Yep. So she essentially sent us on a wild goose chase. Inrani. And it's strange. I mean, he said that there's only one temple that accepts non-Hindu, what do you call them, visitors, but this is Durga's temple. That is a different goddess, not Shiva. I'm guessing this guy's gonna come out again.
I'm trying to find the cemetery where a Hindu friend might be buried. There are no Hindu cemeteries in Varanasi.
Now then. That's the same guy again.
We fling the poles into the river so the pigeons can land.
I see.
You never know. A pigeon could be one of our relatives, reincarnated.
I dip my sari in...
And is there anywhere else that I can go here? Somewhere here, perhaps? I don't have anything in my inventory either.
I sweep before I step, so that I might not kill any insects. I cover my nose and mouth, so that I might not accidentally suck in any living creature and cause it harm. In my religion, we believe to kill anything at all is wrong.
How about killing time? Is that okay?
I have to ask.
That's a Jain. Jains don't... there are like two types of Jains, and the ones that wear white clothes like that believe that they should not consciously harm any living organism. Alright, now that one's out of the way, does that unlock anything for us?
I've seen a lot of incredible things here in India.
No doubt you visited the Taj Mahal.
No, I didn't have time.
Didn't have time? You must at least know the story behind it.
Can't say that I do.
Ah, what a story. Would you like to hear it?
Another song?
I was in the original cast of Les Miserables.
That was beautiful. I have a job to finish. I really must go.
Yeah, I did that. Of course, now that unlocked the damn stick there. So what are we supposed to do with the stick again?
Jai Gurudeva, I am meditating.
Thank you.
I'm trying to find the cemetery where a Hindu friend might be buried.
There are.
Alright, so what can we do with the stick now? Give it to this kid?
How far can you throw it?
I guess we try throwing the stick then. For the new runt. 2¾. Ah, there's a pigeon.
Oh dear me. I am here to mourn the passing of my cousin, a sultry, sexy, sassy pigeon from New York.
New York?
Yes, my poor, kind cousin was trying to catch up with a Pink Panther friend. My cousin only wanted to protect Pink.
Oh, no.
I kill me. I really do.
Okay, that was inconsequential. Oh, wait, that guy's active now.
Don't cry. It'll grow back. I remember my first short haircut. I didn't like it one bit.
No, my head is shaved because I'm the chief mourner. My grandfather died. It's a Hindu tradition for the chief mourner to shave his head.
Ah, so you're not sad about your haircut. You're sad about your grandfather dying?
I'm not sad. Today we're celebrating the passing of my grandfather.
You didn't like him.
We love him.
Then why are you celebrating?
Today he is reborn. No one can cry. It's bad luck.
He asked to be cremated?
He does not have to ask. It is his right. We are Hindu, so that is our tradition. It is every Hindu's wish to have their ashes scattered in the Ganges.
And so you're not sad?
I will miss my grandfather, but I will see him again. As Hindus, we believe that only the body dies, not the soul. My grandfather's soul will be released and he will be reincarnated.
Reincarnated?
He will come back as something else, depending on what his karma is. My grandfather was a kind man, so his karma is good.
I see. Say, I have to bring these flowers to the grave of a friend. Can you tell me where the Hindu graveyard in Varanasi is?
But I told you, there is no graveyard. In Varanasi, this river is Hindu's only graveyard.
Why wouldn't Inrani know that? She's from Varanasi. The plot sure is thickening. I guess I'll just try to find some marigolds for Indrani's grandfather and leave them in the river.
Namaste!
Namaste!
So, here's my personal theory. I think what happened was those children have been replaced with robots. And that's the reason we saw that arm at the beginning crawling away. So, right now what we need to do is get some marigolds. That temple, of course, maybe that temple comes in use now.
Hello, I am the priest at Durga's temple. The only temple that allows non-Hindus.
Namaste!
Those are some pink marigolds, apparently. Strange that it wouldn't let us get those marigolds before this point in time. Never seen pink marigolds before, but oh well, this is Pink Panther.
I thought you said you needed marigolds. Those are violets.
I know where I can get marigolds, but it's very, very far. It involves a long outdoor train ride back to Bombay.
When you gotta go, you gotta go.
Okay, fine. Oh, I mean, you can get marigolds in Varanasi as well. You don't need to go all the way to Bombay to get some. These two lovebirds have been here ever since the very beginning. So the rest of the people in the tree. And this cow here. A traveling cow.
Back so soon?
Namaste, kid. Don't go anywhere. I'm going to need you to get back to Victoria Terminal.
Okay!
But where are you
Slight
going?
Slight communication gap.
Mm-hmm. Alright, Marigolds then.
Marigolds, do you have any?
Indeed, I do.
Please, I just came from Varanasi and I need some flowers to put in the Ganges River.
Varanasi, the holy Ganges River. Of course, of course.
That was easy.
Wait a minute. How do I know you really need those flowers to bring to the holy Ganges River in Varanasi? I want proof.
And what can I bring here for proof? I guess we're going all the way back to Varanasi now. Apparently we can't go there yet. The spices, maybe? Spice.
What seems to be the problem?
You're a psychic. Can you please confirm that the marigolds I need are for the sacred Ganges River in Varanasi?
Who do I look like, Dion Warlock? Okay, kid, I'll help you. Just cause you're cute. You know the drill. Show me your paw. I am the great Polly. The panther's words are true. He just came from the Ganges River and... It's coming in a bit foggy, Panther. Can you stand on one foot? Maybe I'll get a better reception. Oh, you had it a minute ago. There, it's coming in perfectly clear. The panther needs to place the marigolds in the Ganges River to put a young girl at ease.
And that's the truth.
Thank you.
Sure thing. Now in, boys, here.
Marigolds for the holy Ganges River, of course.
All right then.
I am sorry I ever doubted you. Please say, what's up, to Shiva for me.
Will do.
Those
now to head back
either.
To Victoria Terminal.
And she's back. Yeah, those are marigolds. A lot of back and forth. A lot of back and forth.
VT? I'm on my way there now! I'll show you the way!
I'll say this for you, kid. You got great timing.
It's like... the Pink Panther is pushed up against the cat's... Against the cow's butt. This game is sort of like really padded out with all the back and forth travel. Sort of makes this a boring experience, in my opinion.
4 your grandfather, Inrani.
The weather here at camp is very bad. I have something important I must talk to you about. I'm sending transport. Can you hear me? Pink!
Something rotten is going on in Camp Chiliwawa. I just know it.
Oh, damn. And have you turned into a robot as well?
Lon Smarty, are you okay?
Yeah, sorry, Pink. I need to lie down. Can't talk, must rest.
Where are all the children?
Can't talk, must rest.
Lon Smarty, I've got to stop this rain. Lon Smarty will drown.
The rain, Pink, must not get wet.
I wonder if Marty is a robot to begin with. I see, that's why he's doing all this. Well, there's one way to get rid of the rain, then.
There's a stick jammed in the controls. That must be what's causing the rain.
Then how about we get rid
There's
of the stick?
There's a stick jammed in the...
Of course, you can't just get rid of the stick, can you? You have to find some way to do that. We can still enter the houses. Half the houses are missing. There are only 3 houses now. Let's go downstairs first. Let's see if we have anything of value here.
Secret hiding place.
We don't have anything to put in there anymore.
A crowbar.
That should come in handy. Especially to unjam the stick from there. Let's talk to this guy since we have begun this chapter anyway.
Isn't this great, Pink? Chili Wawa is a success!
How so?
Well...
That guy's losing his stuff. Yeah, let's use the crowbar with this. Stick there.
Come again some other day!
Look at the dial, it's still stuck, but looks like this guy's moving.
Yes! Fine work, Pink! Fine work! Perhaps we should rest again!
Rest? The kids are missing! The place is in ruins! We haven't...
That guy's also been replaced at this point in time. And, yeah, this was it for our tour of India. The next time we come back, we will be essentially solving the mystery of this camp. And, well, moving on to Australia, the last continent there is. Or rather, the last location there is in the game. Pretty sure it'll lead there. And I can see some clues right here as to what could have possibly happened, but I'll be addressing that the next time I come back. So until then, thank you for tuning in, thank you for watching, and thank you for sticking around until the end. Take care. Fare thee well, fellow Earthlings.